This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to do some work with an exponential decay problem. So here's our problem. This says the exponential decay function for uranium-232, or U-232, is A of t equals A sub O times E raised to the negative 0.0099 t. And then the question it asks is, what is the half-life of U-232? Okay, so to find the half-life, what I'm going to do is assume that I began with, let's say, 1 gram, and I ended up with a half a gram. And I want to plug that information into this function and find out what t is, what the length of time it would take, what that length of time would be, to turn 1 gram into 1/2 a gram. So I'm going to have A of t, that's the amount I have at the end, is 0.5, equals A sub O, that's the amount I'm beginning with, that's 1, times E raised to the negative 0.0099 t. And I want to find out what the t is. Okay, so I'm going to do this by taking the natural log of both sides. To begin with, maybe what I want to do is cross out this 1, since it's really not necessary there. Now I'll take the natural logs. So I'm going to have ln of 0.5 equals ln, the natural log, of e to the negative 0.0099 t. I'll take this exponent and make it a coefficient for the logarithm. So now I'll have the natural log of 0.5 equals negative 0.0099 t times the natural log of e. Okay, well, the natural log of e is 1, so we'll cross that part out. I want to get the t by itself, so I'll divide both sides of the equation by negative 0.0099. That leaves the t all by itself on the right side of the equation. The left side, I've got the natural log of 0.5 over negative 0.0099. So I'll take a calculator, find out what that equals. I want the natural log of 0.5, and I want to divide that by negative 0.0099. Okay? And when I do that, I get t equals approximately 70.0148. This number is going to keep going. Let's just round that off into 70 years. Okay? So the half-life of U-232 would be 70 years. There's a second part to this problem. The second part says, if a sample initially contained 200 grams, how much would remain after 300 years? Okay, so let's go back to this formula. A of t, t stands for time, so I want the amount A of 300, the amount after 300 years. And that's going to equal A sub O. A sub O is the amount we begin with. That's 200 grams. I'm going to multiply that by E to the negative 0.0099 t. And t, once again, is 300. Okay, so this is pretty straightforward. We'll just plug the right side of the equation into the calculator. So I want 200 times E to the negative 0.0099 times 300. And what I get is A of 300, or the amount I have left, is going to equal, will equal approximately 10.26066. Again, this is a number that keeps going. Let's just round this to 10.26 grams. Okay, now with a problem like this, since we know the half-life, we can see if this answer makes sense. So let's do that. Let's make a table, and the table will be the number of years that have gone by and the number of grams that we have left. So if we start out at year zero, we've got 200 grams. After 70 years, that's one half-life, we'll have half as much, so we'll have 100 grams. 70 years later, or at 140 years, we'll have half as much again, so that's 50 grams. After 210 years, another 70, we'll have half of 50, that's 25. 70 years later gets us to 280 years, and we'll have half of 25, which is 12.5. And our answer said that after 300 years, we had 10.26 grams. So looking at the table and the way the weight, the number of grams, is deteriorating, it seems like it would be reasonable to assume that after 300 years, we would in fact have 10.26 grams. Okay? So I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.